and welcome to my channel. Today I've got a make a tutorial for you on this look. Basically, I've been listening to a lot of gothic music lately that I loved in high school. And then I wanted to do something dark and smoky. But not too dark and smoky. I just wanted to do a smoky wing, and this is just what it turned into, basically. Like, it's still something quite, I don't know, like, it's glam, it's wearable, it's dark, it's not actually all that difficult to do. So let's just hurry up and get onto it. Starting off with priming my eyelids with the Maybelline Color Tattoo this time, because I haven't used it in a while, and otherwise I'm going to end up accidentally letting it dry out, and then when I want to use it again, I'll find out then that it's dried out, which would suck. So basically I'm using it because I haven't used it in a while. Okay, now for eyeshadows, basically you're going to need nude shades and blue shades, and preferably also a glittery blue shade and also an eye pencil. I just dropped the brush. Anyway, for the eyeshadows, I'm going to use the Jeffree Star Cosmetics Blue Blood Palette, but of course you can use whatever eyeshadows you have in those colors. As always, I'm just starting off with a transition shade. I'm using pretty much just a very neutral toned taupe shade. And yes, I'm using a different fluffy blender. I have actually washed the other one, but... well, because I used this one a couple of times because the other one dried in a weird shape, I actually realized that I actually quite like this one. It's a little bit more firm, but it blends really, really nicely and is extremely soft. I feel like the other one is just wearing down because I use it so often. I also sort of feel now like I'm cheating on my other big fluffy blender because I used to use it all the time. Because that's how my brain works. I honestly feel guilty towards the freaking makeup brush. But yeah, anyway. We're just gonna ignore that and apply the transition. Now, the eyelid I'm gonna keep really simple. I'm just going to use a very nude shade, a very pale nude shade. A very nude shade. Huh? Anyway, I'm just going to apply that to the inner one third of the eye, then move on to a slightly darker matte nude shade, and then to the crease shade. Just to fill up the eyelids, because I want to keep it quite natural. By the way, ever since like the whole lockdown situation, has your social media preference changed, I wonder? Because I've been noticing for some reason, I don't know, like I used to be on Twitter quite a lot. And then I had more time to be on Twitter because, you know, we can't go anywhere in the weekend. So yeah, I've actually been avoiding Twitter now for a while because it's not good for my feelings towards humanity in general to be on Twitter, I feel. For one weird reason, really. Well, maybe it's not a weird reason. But, like, there's a lot of people on Twitter who sprout their opinion as if it's a fact and as if everyone has to agree with it. And it pisses me off. Like, really, like, I don't know, like, even as a child, you know, like, I hated it when people tried to decide what I had to like or what I had to think. And I just feel that way with Twitter, too, like, I don't know, like, I've just been really way more into, like, the Instagram. It's just way more fun. It doesn't make me despise people I don't even know, which is also nice. I don't know, like, how is that for you? Do your social media preferences change, or are they just the same as always? And by the way, just doing my brow bone while I'm at it anyway. It's not even like the people I follow on Twitter that piss me off. No, it's the annoying thing on Twitter that you see basically everything that, like, well, not everything, but you also see stuff that other people who you follow like. I don't know, we all know how Twitter works. But, like, really, I wish there was just a button that would just allow you to just see the stuff that the people you actually follow post, rather than everything that, you know, random people they follow post, and I don't really care about. I mean, really? I just want to follow the people I follow, and not, like, you know, half their extended family. Basically. So, next step, this is what we're going for. We're gonna start off with a black pencil, sharpened, obviously, because otherwise you can't do this. And I'm just going to carefully, basically create a winged liner. Yeah, the two things you need to know, basically, are use a pencil, use a creamy pencil, because we're going to need to, like, smudge this out a little bit. So you don't want a product that dries and then stays in place and becomes completely immovable, because that would not work out well for this particular purpose. And also, it doesn't need to be perfect. Like, I want it to be a wing. I don't want it to be too smudgy. I still want there to be a shape to it. But don't worry if you, for example, don't get the wing completely tight and, like, sleek and all. Because, again, we're going to smudge it, so it doesn't really matter that much. So, yeah, make a bit of an effort, but don't worry about it too much. Then, back to the eyeshadows. I'm going to use a smudging brush. Wait. Yeah. Very short, very stump. Very smudgy. It's quite stiff. I mean, like, it's not painful on the eyelid or anything. Brushes never should be. But it's very soft, so I can just... Well, it's soft yet firm. I can use it to smudge. That's basically the thing. You need a smudging brush. I'm making this way more complicated than it needs to be. Anyway, I'm just going to use a pale blue eyeshadow onset brush. And start going over the eye pencil. And I'm really going over the edge of the pencil a little bit. Just so I get the blue to really be visible. By the way, if you want to do this in like more of a pastel way, you can always use a white pencil instead. But I really wanted the darkness there anyway, because I just like a dark liner. Then with a bold blue, pretty much a blue of my nails, I'm going to do the middle part in the same way. And of course you can go over it like way more heavily than I am. Like if you really want the blue to be way more visible, you can do that as well, but I want to keep it subtle. I know it's a rare thing, me and subtle, like it totally doesn't go together usually, but this time I just wanted to try. But yeah, just smudging it and you'll just see that the line of the pencil will also look smooth in the end. Whether or not it was to begin with. And then for the outer corner I'm just using a very dark shade of blue, almost a black. And finish off the wing. And again, I don't need this to be perfect, because this is a smoky sort of wing. But I do want the tip to be in existence, basically. You can always tidy it up afterwards when doing the face makeup anyway. And then on the very outer corner, I'm just using a little bit of... Oh, it was only my hair. I thought that my battery was flashing red at me. Not important, anyway. I'm just going to dab that over the darkest part of the wing, like... The wing of the eyeliner, basically. Yeah. And be gentle with this, because otherwise... Well, this is a blue glitter eyeshadow I'm using. And with any blue glitter eyeshadow, with any glitter eyeshadow overall, you know it's going to be everywhere for the rest of your life if you're not careful with it, so be careful. Okay, now next step is optional, but I want a little bit more definition like I did right here already, because, like... Well, I mean, it really depends on your eye shape. I mean, there's a lot of people... Whoa, it suddenly got bright. Anyway, there's a lot of people for who this would just look fine. I mean, it doesn't look bad overall, really, because, you know, it is a complete look, I guess. But for me personally, I prefer to have a little bit more detail in the crease, because otherwise I just feel like I have this really large, bare spot there without anything really going on. So, yeah, I'm going to apply a dark grey shade and just... Well, not really dark grey, not near black or anything, just something that looks like a shadow, basically. Blue undertones, and just blend it out with a teeny tiny blender brush. I wanted to tell you what the official name was, but it faded off. Anyway, it was an XO Beauty brush, and I think it was like... It's a small blender brush. The name is not important, it's a small blender brush. and I'm just going to apply this shade in the crease, like in the deepest part of the crease, and then blend it up gently. Just to give a little bit more shadow there, just so there's something more of a definition there. Looks a bit better, I think. Now, for the inner corner highlight, I'm going to use a cream product. So I'm just putting it in my inner corner and then using an eyeshadow brush to blend it out. And I do recommend doing this per eyeball. Per inner corner, not straight into the eyeball. You get what I mean, because most cream products, this one is Catrice. Which is the only one I personally ever tried. But I think most cream products tend to just dry and then be dry and not move anymore. So yeah, if you still want to be able to blend it out, just work per eye so you actually have a chance to blend it. Now I'm just going to leave the eyes alone for a little bit and do foundation first. By the way, I did apply fake tan on my face. But I did it last night, and then this morning I applied fake tan to the rest of my body, so I've actually managed to have my face be darker than the rest of my body now. So I actually need to make it a little bit paler with foundation. Yeah. I never managed that before. But I'm going to have to actually make myself paler with foundation this time around. So yeah, just gonna do that. Now I've already done concealer and powder as well, just because I don't feel like that's really interesting to show every single time. Now I'm just gonna do my eyebrows. I'm just filling them in, not really naturally, but just... I don't know, basically the lazy way, like outlining them faintly and then just filling them in, basically. Going for more of a shadow than the really hair strokes. It's always amazing how much better an eye look looks at the moment you've done your eyebrows. Like, it's like freaking magic. Anyway, I'm just doing a contour now. I'm not gonna bronze because, like I said, my face is already darker than my body at this point. Less so now that I've applied the foundation, but still. So I'm just gonna keep it very natural and not go overboard with it and use it as a bronzer or anything. I'm really just creating shadows where I want shadows to stand out. I did do a video all about contouring a while back, but it was like mostly focused on cream products versus powder products. But basically, if you're new to contouring, just follow the bone structure of the face. For blush, I'm just picking a natural peachy tone, just because it fits with anything, including this. For highlight, I did contemplate going for a bluish shade for a moment, but then I decided to just toss on a heap of a goldish shade, because it fits with the inner corner. This is also by Catrice, the entire lid fell off. Now, back to the eyes. The bottom eye is going to look like this. I'm just basically going to grab the dark shade, the darkest, almost black shade on the smudging brush and just... Okay, that was a bit over the top maybe, but my point is just tap it off really, really well. And I'm just connecting it to the wing here. So it creates a nice, I don't know, just like a natural transition from the wing to the bottom eyelid. And pull it inwards till about a little bit over halfway. And then I'm going to use a fluffy blender, the tiny fluffy blender. Pale blue shade, tap it off really well again and just blend it together there. Just so the bottom lip becomes just as smudgy as the top lid. Just because it's springtime and all, and I want to not make it too dark, I'm just using a nude pencil on the waterline. Then for falsies are optional, of course. You don't need to use them, you can just use mascara if you want. But I feel like using big falsies today, so I'm going to use a faux mink pair. Because, you know, sometimes you just feel like it. Okay, now that the falsies are on, I feel like my outer corner isn't dark enough, so I'm using like a teeny tiny bit of black eyeshadow on my smudging brush. Just to darken up the wing a little bit. And whatever you do, make sure you don't get fallout at this point, because that would be tragic. Now my top lashes are already black because I tint them, my bottom lashes are too, but I want them to be a little bit thicker, so I am going to apply mascara to my bottom lashes. By the way, if you have less long bottom lashes, there are actually falsies for the bottom eyelid. I never really use them, I don't have them actually, because mine are already pretty long. But it's an option. And lastly, the lips. I feel like with all the coolness going on, despite the gold highlight and all, I need something more warm on my lips, so I'm going to use a warm nude shade to do that. Yep. Okay, surprisingly enough, despite my eternal zombie lips, it looks good. So we're done. we're left with the final results. So yeah, as always, I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you want to know exactly what products I've used today, I put all of it in a list in the video description. When you're watching this, like when I'm saying this, I still need to make that whole entire long list. Anyway, but that will be there. If you want to see more of my videos, you can always subscribe to my channel. I do at least 2 makeup tutorials per week, and then 1 other video that's completely random. At any rate, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!